1903, the Wright brothers make a historic first flight of a powered aircraft, the Wright Flyer. It skipped just 20 feet over the ground for 12 seconds before landing, only 120 feet away.
Have you ever been there?
No, I haven't.
Oh,
but
I
the
went there with my daughter.
Flights were short-lived.
It's fabulous.
Just several years later,
do they have quite a
new challenges and
yes,
memorial?
They have a big museum, and then they have the point where they started, and then their first attempt, their second attempt, their third attempt.
I read the book about them, but I haven't been there. It's on an island, right?
It's on the, not an island, it's on the, banks, the outer banks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
New to the battlefield.
So you can get there by car?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Heroes were born. A newly redesigned French Bat 8 took flight over Western Europe. With a top speed of 135 miles per hour and dives reaching over 200 miles per hour, the new Spads helped turn the war. Air racing dominated the 1930s. The GB Model Z was the smallest possible airframe built around the largest possible engine. It was tricky to fly, but it was fast. Advances in aerodynamics and engines became essential in the coming decades as new generations of pilots pushed airplanes to new limits.
Mustangs, Mustangs. Spitfires, one engine, the other two of it. Always welcome to hell, gents. Happy flying. Extra spit, spot a fuck hot. Diving fast, breaking.
Today, They achieve breathtaking feats in the world's most advanced aircraft.
Fast moving a beam to clear the groove. Bearing 035. Part 1 detected plane and you're clear for landing 15,000 feet.
Roger. I'm in the groove. At 330.
Land on the carrier probably.
That light they call the meatball. Nothing like the real thing.
No, I bet. You've done that?
No.
No?
No. A friend of mine, though, was a Navy pilot.
Far beyond our dreams. And where will future flights of courage take us next?